Welcome back to Screen Lab, where you find anything and everything about film and television. In this video, we will be listing down the top 8 best Western movies you must see before you die. In this list, we will include the roots, the classics, and the modern take on the most popular film genre in Hollywood. Prepare your hat and boots and be ready to get down and dirty, because today, we will be hopping into the gritty, savage, yet classic cowboy life. Make sure to stick until the end to have a 360 look at the Old West.
He's one tough son of a bitch.
Opening our list is 310 to Yuma.
Where's the 310 to Yuma?
This film is the modern adaptation on the 1957 classic. This 2007 film tells the story of a rancher and a Civil War veteran played by Christian Bale, who takes on the dangerous job of taking a notorious outlaw, Russell Crowe, to justice. Better be ready, because in this film, there will be buckets of blood, but visualized in a modern and stylish way. With James Mangold brilliantly crafted 310 to Yuma, plus the feat in Papa Michael's visually stunning cinematography, maximizing the vast landscape of New Mexico, 310 to Yuma successfully established a harsh and his honest world. Number 7. High Noon. Ask your grandma if she has seen this, because this might be one of the oldest in our list. If you think Western is all about breaking the law, this one is different. Rendered in black and white, this undeniable Western classic features Gary Cooper as the small town sheriff, who is forced to face a band of killers alone, because, unfortunately, the people in his town refuse to help him and insisting his disappearance in their town. The tension buildup within the story was masterful, while the screenwriting is interesting. High Noon was written by an ex-member of the American Communist Party. That's why it was seen as a protest against McCarthyism and blacklisting. But despite the controversy, the Oscars speak for themselves. So far, so good? Even though Westerns are your grandpa's favorite, your love for the classic brought you here. Keep on watching, because our number 5 pick is a remake that gave justice to one of the 1950s finest.
People gotta talk themselves into law and order before they do anything about it.
Up next is another modern masterpiece, Django Unchained. Well, how can we miss on the works of one of the greatest Western filmmakers? Quentin Tarantino? Tarantino again took the road less traveled, breaking the standards of Western filmmaking, giving a stylized modern take on life during the 19th century in the Deep South. Coined as Tarantino's love letter to the spaghetti Western, this film features Jamie Foxx, a black slave, hoping to be reunited with his long-lost wife. Leonardo DiCaprio also joins the star-studded cast as the heartless owner of the Candyland plantation. Despite the variety of opinions about this movie, Django Unchained is bold, brutal, hilarious, and still one of the best Westerns that peek through the facts of American history.
I like the way you die, boy.
Number 5. The Grit. Usually, remakes are cringy and less brilliant than the original. But let's just say the Coen brothers gave justice when they took the challenge of remaking the Charles Portis novel. In 1969, John Wayne took The Grit on a silver screen, but this modern classic is way better. This film is braver and less glamorous, perfectly fit the story of a man helping a young girl who is seeking revenge over his father's murder. Jeff Bridges delivers one of his finest performances as mumbling drunk U.S. Marshal Rooster Coburn, whilst newcomer Hailee Steinfeld is mesmerizing in the lead role. Enjoying all these spinning rifles and endless gunfights? Keep on watching, because there's more. Plus, wait until you see our top pick, which was the film inspiration of one of the Western geniuses today.
You're my father, and I'm afraid nothing is going to be done about Cheney except I do it.
Number 4. The Searchers. Going back to the roots of Western film, The Searchers has been described as the pinnacle of John Wayne and John Ford's collaboration. The Searchers still stands as one of the all-time great Westerns. It depicts the typical Western film about the life of a frontier hero, bridging civilization and the wilderness. comes back to the wild to help those who were left to survive. This incredibly complex tale that gives Wayne his most complex character of all, Ethan Edwards, a loyal follower of the Confederacy, overly racist and obsessed with tracking down his niece after she's captured by Indians. This film was visually stunning. It's hard to miss this out from the list of must-see Western films.
Yes. I found Lucy back in the canyon.
Number 3. The Good, the Bad, and the Ugly. Sergio Leone created an epic finale to end his epic dollars trilogy with this film. The plot concerns three bounty hunters, which include the master of the genre, Clint Eastwood, on the trail of buried treasure. Everything is perfect. The music, the cinematography, the screenplay. This film showed Leone's expertise by taking everything he learned from his first two westerns and channeled into a masterpiece, where seamlessly included a Civil War sequence that made the plot one of the best. But the highlight of this film was when the three anti-heroes meet, which was one of the greatest confrontations ever made in the Western genre. How to top a masterpiece? Well, by another masterpiece.
Yes, very good for the digestion.
Number 2. Unforgiven. This neoclassical film, produced, directed, and starred by Clint Eastwood, the man who redefined the Western film genre. Unforgiven follows the story of retired Old West gunslinger William Money reluctantly takes on one last kill with the help of his old partner, Ned Logan, played by Morgan Freeman, that resulted to regret and contemplation. This instant classic gives a modern touch to the Old West. Plus, it gives the genre a new shade. Inspired by his mentors, Sergio Leone and Don Siegel, Unforgiven defined Eastwood's long and prosperous career by winning at the Academy Award for Best Director and Best Picture, which is, by the way, just the third time for this specific genre. If you're having a hard time thinking what title will top all of that, we have the answer. Number 1. Once Upon a Time in the West. The film that gets Quentin Tarantino into filmmaking. Tarantino admits that the spaghetti western and the visually stunning and musical interpretation of Sergio Leone is his inspiration. That alone quickly gives this masterpiece the top spot. You know you're watching a badass film when the lead star kills a child in his first scene. The film exhibits two conflicts: a land battle related to the construction of a railroad, and revenge against a cold-blooded killer. That takes place around Flagstone, a fictional town in the American Old West. Many of Leone's followers will agree that this is his crowning achievement. In this film, Leone proved he could still make great Western films. Following the success of his Dollars trilogy, and who would have thought that playing the harmonica could be badass? Whew, that was exhausting. Let us know which is your best pick in this video at the comment section. If you enjoyed the top 8 best Western movies you must watch before you die, you will definitely have a good time watching our other video, 8 best action movies of all time. Do not forget to subscribe to Screen Lab and click the notification button for the latest updates and top picks about movies and television. Thanks for watching.